Today, we will talk about a business regarding as a classification of industries. Classification of industries. Classification of industries. As we discussed regarding as a factors affecting as a location of industries, factors affecting the location of industries where in which as a different geographical and a non-geographical factors are responsible for location of industries. So keeping in mind of these factors, the most appropriate and a profitable site is selected. Industrialization of any area initiates the urbanization and subsequent modernization. Infrastructural facilities intensifies the water and supply, efficient banking and credit facilities and transport network. Industrialization attracts labor force also. An area becomes the hub of the activities generating diverse employment, developing service sector. In short, we can say as a center of a transformation into a town or a city. When we are studying about the Nakodar, adjoining parts of Jalandhar, Adampur, Guraya, these smaller number of towns at present, earlier these were as the not due to as a growth of industries in these areas, these areas now has become as a town or a cities. So obviously, industrialization helps in removing the regional disparities and poverty by providing the jobs to the people. Our policy, it should be to diffuse the industrialization to different parts in non-industrial areas. Earlier, industrial development had colonial character. Industrial development took place in areas like as a Kolkata, Chennai, such of the presidency cities. In these areas, Britishers, they invested for the earning of their profits. Industrialization and urbanization go hand in hand. Cities provide as a ready markets and infrastructural facilities. Other industries take advantage of existing facilities and get established. Such cities are referred to as the urban economies or agglomeration economies. Urban economies or agglomeration economies, where due to as a support of a larger cities, the smaller towns, they develops. Smaller towns develop under influence of a larger city. Due to as an influence of a Jalandhar, the adjoining towns, they develop. Nakodar develop. Due to as a influence of a Delhi, Noida, Gurgaon, these towns develop. Such kind of a development in a smaller towns in a suburban areas is known as a agglomeration economies. Economies. Agglomeration economies. For example, as adjoining to the Ludhiana, the Filor developed. Due to as influence of a Ludhiana, Filor developed. But in some parts of India are there where the, which are known for the hub of industries, such kind of areas are known as SEZs, special economic zones. Special economic zones. In southern India, as adjoining parts of Bangalore, these areas are developed due to the concentration of software, hardware-based industries, IT-based industries. Cotton textiles concentrated in western parts of a country in Maharashtra and Gujarat, known for the cotton textiles, iron and steel industries are concentrated in southeastern parts of a country, the parts of Odisha, Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh. So special economic zones are also being asset developed, which will give in a boost to the employment, urbanization, and competition. These regions are developed and improved the share of a secondary sector in GDP of our country, national income, increases as the share in a national income. Next, as a classification of a industries. Tell there any questions? Any questions? Yes, any questions? Industries are broadly classified into the five broader categories on the basis of capital investment or scale. On the basis of a capital investment or scale, three types of industries are there. Cottage industries, first classification based upon the basis of a capital investment, scale or production. So three types of industries are there. Small scale industries, cottage industries, large scale industries. Now which are now known as the multinational companies, MNCs. Multinational companies. On the basis of a capital investment, scale or a production, there are three types of the industries are there. Cottage industries, small scale industries, and large scale industries. Second classification based upon ownership, public, private, public sector, private sector, joint sector, and cooperative sector, public sector, private sector, joint sector, cooperative sector. Next classification of industries based upon nature of raw material or weight of raw material, heavy industries and lightweight industries. Such industries are also known as footloose industries, which can be as a located at any part of a country because the type of a raw material used in such industries as a light in weight and smaller in quantities. Next classification on the basis of source of raw material. Fourth category, on the basis of source of raw material. Industries are agro-based industries. Second, mineral-based industries. mineral based industries. Third, maritime industries, MARITIME. Fourth, pastoral based industries. And fifth, forest based industries on the basis of a source of a raw material. Agro based industries, mineral based industries, maritime, pastoral based and forest based. Last fifth category, on the basis of their role or type of product. Two types of industries are there. Basic industries on the basis of role or type of product. Basic industries. Second are the consumer goods industries. So these are the major five classification of industries which are categorized under secondary sector in our country. Let's start from the first classification based upon a scale. So on the basis of scale, first, capital investment, cottage, small and large scale industries, the capital investment, less than 20 lakhs of money invested in a growth of a cottage industries, less than 20 lakhs of money invested in a cottage industries, 20 lakhs to the 1 crore in a small scale industries and more than the 1 crore in a large scale industries. More than 1 crore capital investment in large scale industries, which are also known as a multinational companies, not only as a one nation, different countries of the world collectively responsible for a production in a such industries. Clear? Production in a such industries. Market. So after production, cottage industries, their products are consumed in a localities. Production of goods consumed in local rural areas or its adjoining areas. Small scale industries, their goods selling towards throughout the country, within a state or in adjoining states. Whereas a large scale industries, their products are moving towards the different countries of the world. Cottage industries, their products consumed in a local areas, in village or in their adjoining areas. Small scale industries, their goods selling within a country. Large scale industries, their goods are also selling towards as an international level, towards the different countries of the world. Labor, labor for a cottage industries. For a cottage industries, professionally qualified laborers are not desirable. Generally, as a desired laborers are those which transfer the skills from a generation to generation. Those who attain skills for manufacturing of goods from one generation towards other. One generation towards other. Skilled workers are required, not as a professionally qualified. Cottage industries. In a small scale industries, skilled labor desirable. Small scale industries, skilled workforce desirable for a production. Desired for production. Small scale industries, skilled workforce desired for production. And in large scale industries, both. Large scale industries are both skilled and unskilled. Skilled and unskilled workforce required. Skilled workforce for a extraction of a minerals from the mines. Unskilled workforce required for the extraction of minerals from mines. And skilled workforce for running of machines. Skilled and unskilled, both the types of laborers are required for a large scale industries. Large scale industries. Skilled and unskilled, both the types of the workforce required for a manufacturing processes. In large scale industries. Next. Products. What kind of the products are produced in a cottage industries? Cottage industries. We discussed regarding as the first classification. Classification based on a production or a scale. Three types of the industries are there. Cottage industries, small scale industries, and large scale industries. Second classification, on the basis of a source of raw material. On the basis of source of raw material, agro-based industries. Those industries which obtain their raw material from agriculture. Industries obtained their raw material. Agro-based industries are those industries which obtain their raw material from agriculture. Cotton textiles, sugar, etc. Second, mineral-based industries. These industries obtain raw material primarily from minerals, directly from the minerals. After the mining, those minerals which are extracted beneath the layers of earth crust are used for a manufacturing of goods known as a mineral-based industries. These are also known as a metallurgical industries. Metallurgical industries. These are also known as the metallurgical industries. Example, iron and steel, pharmaceuticals, petrochemicals, automobiles, fertilizers, aluminium industry, aircraft, paints, glass are comes under their category. I'm again repeating as iron and steel industries, petrochemicals, fertilizers, pharmaceuticals, paint, glass, automobiles, etc. are categorized under the mineral-based industries. These are also known as a metallurgical industries. Metallurgical industries. Third category, pastoral-based industries. those industries which obtain their raw material from animals. Raw materials from animals are known as a pastoral beast. Pastoral beast. In previous year, you learned one of the chapter as a pastoralism. Pastoralism. So pastoral based industries, these industries depend upon animals for their raw material. Depends upon animals for their raw material. Like dairy industry, dairy, woolen textiles, poultry, leather, dairy, woolen textiles, leather, poultry, etc. Next is a maritime, MARITIME. These industries obtain raw material from sea and oceans. Industries obtain their raw material from sea and oceans. Oceans. Example, cod liver oil. C-O-R-D. Cod liver oil. C-O-R-D-L-E-V-E-R. Cod liver oil. Maritime industries. Manufacturing of a salt. Maritime industries. Because they obtained their raw material from oceans and sea. Maritime industries, fisheries, etc. Next are the forest-based industries. These industries use forest products as their raw material. Forest products as their raw material. Like as a medicinal herbs, timber, furniture. Timber means as a furniture, paper, medicinal herbs are directly obtained from the forest lands. Clear? This is as a classification based upon a source of raw material. Based on source of raw material. Till there any questions? Source of raw material. Next, third classification. Classification of industries based on ownership. Classification of industries based on ownership. Public sector industries. These industries are owned and managed by government. Those industries which are owned and managed by government and its agencies, which aims social welfare. Example, BHEL, Bharat Heavy Electrical Limited, BHEL, Bharat Heavy Electricals Limited. Second example, SAIL, Steel Authority of India Limited. First, Bharat Heavy Electricals Limited, Steel Authority of India Limited, or you can also write as a BSNL, Bharat Sanchar Nigam Limited. Such kind of industries are doing as a work for the social welfare. Priority given to the welfare of a people means that they are providing as their services at the low cost, like the BSNL, Bharat Sanchar Nigam Limited. Clear? Public sector industries. Second, private sector industries. Private sector industries. These industries are mostly owned and managed by the individuals or group of individuals. Individuals or group of individuals which are generally work for profits to earn maximum profits. Their aim is to maximize the profit and use best possible available technology. These industries aims to maximize profit and use their best possible available technology and produce competitive products. Example, Godrej Industries, Bombay Dyeing, Airtel, Reliance Textiles, etc. Bombay Dyeing, Reliance, Godrej and Dabur Industries, etc. Clear? Till there any questions? Next are the joint sector industries. Joint sector industries are collectively operated by those industries which are collectively operated by public and private sector agencies. Private and public sector agencies for socio-economic benefits. Example, oil. OIL. Example, oil. Oil India Limited. It is as responsible for availability of a crude oil in Indian subcontinent, which has purchased from OPEC industries, oil producing eastern countries, and afterwards as a such oil has given to the different agencies. HP or Bharat, they are responsible for the availability, the purchasing of oil from a world market and distributing to the different agencies. So these industries are collectively worked by the public and the private sector firms. Next example, PSEB, Punjab State Electricity Board. Government responsible for the availability of electricity and the distribution managed by the private companies. Clear? Joint sector industries. And the fourth type under the ownership as a cooperative sector. These industries are owned and operated by those people who has produced and supplied raw materials and market the raw material and market the raw material and finished products. These industries are work on a mutual benefits. Cooperative sector industries are work on a mutual benefits. They put their resources together to run an organization. Example, Amul, Verka, Lejjat Papad earlier started in a form of a cooperative industry. Lejjat Papad, Verka, Amul, Handloom industry in Karnataka, Khadi Bhandar Udyog in Punjab and Gujarat, their works under as a cooperative sector. Clear? So till there any questions? Rest will continue in the rest of the industries on tomorrow. Yes, any questions?